Hello guys, welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to give you a demonstration on power and harmonics analyzer. This analyzer is specially designed for use in inspection and the maintenance department. We can measure the different type of electrical parameters, characteristics of different parameters. The analyzer is specially designed for use of inspection and maintenance department in the electrical section. Also, you can measure the different type of power qualities, power characteristics of the grid within a convenient way. With the dual DSP architecture design and the large scale integrated system and with the embedded programming, this analyzer can measure multiple type of electrical characteristics with a very quick results output. So now we move on to the complete description of all the features of this analyzer. Also, we will operate it to see some basic features on this video. So this is our power quality analyzer. The order code is 19204576.41. You can use this order code to find out all the specification, all the details about this power quality analyzer, and these are some accessories which are also included in this complete setup. So this is the AC adapter with battery charger. So you can use the adapter to charge the battery. It takes about 6 hours to charge the complete battery in the full level, and the battery after one charge can be worked up to 7 hours continuous working. Then we have voltage connection probes. The voltage connection probes will come with the alligator clips, so you can connect them to all the three phases, and the ground and earthing wires are also provided for this connection. And also you can connect this clamp meter or the CT clamp to be on any of the power rating. This can work up to 1000 amperes in the K3 certification. Also, a LAN cable is provided with this complete system. The analyzer can also be worked remotely with the software provided with this kit, so that you can install the software in your PC by which you can connect it to this LAN at a remote location, and you can monitor all the data on the computer screen as well. And a handy bag and case is also provided, so you can easily take the complete setup to move at any of the point in your power grid or any of the location where you want to do measurements. So these are all the basic information about the accessories and the overview of this power quality analyzer. Now we will move on to turning it on, and later on we'll see some important features that are required with working. So this is the closed loop of this power and quality harmonic analyzer. Now this has a complete big large screen. This is a color screen so that we can easily monitor all the data in variant color. And this is an easy to use keyboard. These are the keys. I will explain you all the function of one by one. This is the power on key for this analyzer. So we'll first power on this. For turning it on, first make sure the battery is charged until that it can be worked for this. And if the battery is not charged, you can connect the charger to this at the slot provided on the right side of this. And this is the LED indicator, the charger. As the charging is going on, this will be continuously in blinking mode so that it shows us that the analyzer is charging. Now we'll power on this. For this we just need to press this power on button for 2 seconds, and in some time it will be properly boot up and we'll reach to the home screen. Here this is the setup and home screen of this complete system, in which all the main details of this system are described. I will explain you all the points one by one. Now this is the top section of this complete analyzer, in which we have to connect the voltage probes at this A, B, C and neutral terminal, and this is green one is for the ground. Then we have to connect the current probes, which are the clamp which are provided at this BNC section. So we just need to uncover these caps to connect the BNC type of current probes to all the sections. So now we are going to connect all the probes firstly. So this is the current probe which has the BNC male connector over here inside, and we can connect it to any of the section of current clamp. That's how we can connect the current clamp. All the three clamps can be connected over here. Neutral clamp, if provided, you can also use that. And for connecting the voltage probes, use this handy patch cords. The alligator clips are also provided, easy to stuck, stackable type of alligator clip are provided. So we can connect this to any of the line for the two wire single phase system. The red probe can be connected to the phase wire, and the neutral wire can be used with the alligator clip. And for measurement of current, the clamp can be easily used to the load section wire of this. So after turning on the harmonics analyzer, you will reach to the home screen, which is a setup screen for us. So when we press the setup, you can also reach to this screen over here. So as we press setup, the cursor keys are required to use the any of the command. So right now you can see this is the first one, is the user ID. So you can enter any of the desired user ID. You can enter any of the name, any of the number with the characteristics. It can be entered up to the specified length. Space functions is also provided. Just need to press F4 for providing the space of any of the ID. So we can enter any of the ID to this. Just need to configure all the values using this cursor keys. So that's how we have entered the ID. So we have entered the user ID, which is Tesca, and press F5 for OK it. And now we can change the configuration. Whatever the configuration which you are going to measure, you can select it over here. Press enter. The different configurations are provided. You can select them, any of the required configuration, which is 3-phase Y mode, 3-phase IT mode, 3-phase delta, single phase neutral. These are the four different types of mode which are provided on the first page. On page 2, some other modes are also provided: single phase, split phase, single phase IT no neutral, 3-phase high leg, 3-phase open leg. At page 3, some more 2.5 element, 2 elements configurations are also provided. So you can select any of the desired configuration for your working. The connection diagram, whenever you select the desired mode, are also provided. So as on the top side that we have seen, you just need to connect the current on this upper side, and the lower side you need to connect the voltage lines on this system, and also the ground on the ground one. So that's how the connection diagram is also described in this. Also, you can select the frequency, the desired frequency at the system work. So you can select the frequency, whether it is 60 hertz, 50 hertz, or so required frequency will be based on the configuration selection. Also, you can select the nominal voltage for this. So we are working on the 380 volts nominal at the 3-phase for this. You can change them with different modes are also provided, and you can increase or decrease your desired nominal voltage with this. Then the language can be switched from English to Chinese, Portuguese, Francis, Espanol, and different type of language configurations are provided. So we'll do it in English mode. So we'll select English. Also, the clamp, whatever the clamp configurations are using, are provided. So you can change the different type of clamps also. Eye rating, eye range, and eye ratio will be automatically changed depending on the clamp setting. So we are using CTC1535 type of clamp. Voltage ratio is 1:1, eye ratio is 1:1. So we press OK. The other details are also given over here. After that, we have provided some other features also. For user preference, you can press F2 key. The date and time settings can be also provided on this complete setup. You can select any of the date and time where you want to work. LAN setup is also provided for communicating it with the PC. So the IP address, static IP address is provided. Net mask and gateway are the prescribed and predefined. You can select any of the value. And for using the DHCP and static IP setup, you can use it in any form. Press OK, F4 for setting up it, and sleep timer can also be configured. For this, you can select sleep time of 5 minutes, 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 60 minutes, up to 60 minutes. These are provided. We'll set it to off again. And face color, you can select any of the face colors for your desired value. These are the default face colors right now, which are going to see. For L1, we can select any of the face colors using these cursor keys. So we change them to default and press OK. So that's how you can do the basic setups for the complete power and harmonics analyzer. Version and calibrations are also provided. You can also provide any password for calibration changing. Limits are also provided. You can provide the default limit to use. And when you press OK, you just go to menu section where you want to menu and measure the different values from this menu section. Now, explaining about the menu section over here, different options are provided. You can select for measurements, volts, ampere and hertz, dips and swells, harmonics, power and energy, unbalance and logger. Logger is for the data logging of the old parameters. Also, when you press the menu button, you just reach to this screen again. Now, if we are now selected the volts and ampere hertz section, here we will press OK. Here in the tabular form, we are having the numerical values of voltage, current and frequency, waveform factor. Also, when we press F4, we can go to the trend section also. The all L1, L2 and L3 voltage VRMS are provided, so we can see the trends over here. Or for switching the parameter from VRMS to V peak to peak, just need to press the F1 key. These are the crest factor, frequency, IRMS, I peak, CF1, and again VRMS. So that's how we can select different parameters. For going to back, press F4. We again reach to the table section in which all the parameters are provided. Phase or line, you can select them through the F1 mode. And to holding the data, just need to press the hold. Date and time of present and measuring time, real time date and time is provided also. Now after connecting all the probes for current and voltage measurement to the analyzer, we can connect to them at any of the power distribution system, in a 4-wire system or a 2-wire system. Right now I'm having a motor which is connected to a 3-phase system, and I am connecting the all three phases for measuring the voltages on the terminal of this motor right now using these clamps, you can see. So that's how you can connect it to any clamp or any of the power bus bar for measurement of the voltage. For measuring the current, you can connect the clamps to the current meter. Also make sure there is an arrow which is described on this probe, so that the current flow direction should be in the flow of arrow with the matched, and you can easily connect the clamp to all the three terminal wires for measuring the current flow. Now we will see the different measurements and parameters of this three phase system. So right now in the voltage and current section, we are seeing that there is no amount and very minimal amount of the both readings are presented. When we turn on the MCB, the values will be changed, and as the motor starts running, there will be some values of voltage and current. The voltage which is provided to the motor terminals, which is now 426 at line 1, 425 it's between line 2, 3, and in line 3, 1 this is the voltage 426. Peak to peak voltage is 609 and crest factor is 1.43 right now for this power system, and current drawn from the motor at IRMS peak will be line 1, 1.1 around 1.0 and 1.0 in line 2 and 3 as well. So that's how all the readings are in tabular form. We can check them and foresee the trend. Also we can see the voltage trend on the voltage screen. So these are the point at which the voltage will be zero, and the highest value is the 430, which is right now in the trends. And now from this instance the voltage are right now in the higher form, and as we turn off the MCB the voltage will goes down again. For parameter switch, we can see this is the peak to peak voltage. For 10th of the scale, this is the crest factor, this is the frequency which is 50 hertz. In the starting the frequency goes around 50 to 80 hertz, and these are the IRMS current. Current is continuously going up and down for this all the three lines. Now we move to the VRMS again, and as I turn off the MCB you can observe that the trend goes down again. Here with the time you can see now voltage is again come to the 0 volts. So this is about the menu mode. We will see some more values of this menu section. These are the dips and swells. This will be incorporated with the time, and when we turn on the power again we can see the dips and swells also measured in the system. So we can analyze all the parameters of dips and swells which are continuously variable. The current is about 1 ampere from the 0 to 10 scale. Events are logged in different type of dips. These are the dips, interval and swells are provided. You can take down all the readings of this. Cursor is provided for zooming in about the different phases. And this is about dips and swells. All the details are also given in the user manual, so that you can study it also. Now we move to the harmonics center. This is the harmonics menu in which we can measure the different harmonics in the total harmonic distortion, which is about 1.1% for this. And these are the all three phases, harmonic 1, harmonic 2 and harmonic 3. This is of the voltage, and when we press F1 we can go to the current form. In the current the harmonics is about 3.2 9 or 4.0% in the total harmonic distortion, and all the DC values can be measured. The DC harmonics which are present are 0.25, 0.1 at different instants, which are continuously going in the line. This is for line 1, separately we can check it. This is for line 2, this is for line 3, and this is for all the 3 lines. Separately we can do it also for the voltage. And in the metering form, all the harmonics parameters are provided in the numerical form as well. And this is the graphical representation of the harmonics. Now we move on to the next section of the menu. Now in the next section, we have power and energy. In the power energy, different type of powers are measured. These are the power. Total power is about 0.73 in negative kVA, kilowatt kVA, and kVAr are the all powers that we can check. For the energy, these are the different energy. Voltage and currents are continuously are the value. So right now we are doing with the motor a practical for analyzing the different waveforms and values. So power can be measured when we do it practical and connect this analyzer to the any of the power distribution source. Now moving to the next menu option, we are now reached to the unbalanced mode. So we'll enter in this. In the unbalanced displays, phase relation between the voltage and currents is provided. Measuring the results are based upon the fundamental frequency component, which are 50 or 60 Hz, use symmetrical components. In a three-phase power system, the phase shift between voltage and between current should be closer to 120 degrees, and unbalanced mode offers a measurement table in the tabular form and also in the phasor form. For seeing the phasor value, you can just press the vector over here. You can see the V1, which is 425, which is our reference voltage for the in the yellow color, indicated in yellow color. And the second phase is V2, which is about 240 degrees in the phase shift, and V3, which is the red, which is also at 120 degrees phase shift. The phase angles are 0, 241 and 121 for all the voltages. And now we move to the current side. The current values are also different for this. Our current is continuously varying, so that the phasor diagram is also varying for the different values of the current. Here you can see the angle in the degree is also matched up with the unbalanced load. So for perfect measurement of the balance condition can be also achieved with this phasor diagram and on the tabular form as well. The angles are also provided, values of voltage and currents are also provided in this. Now moving to the next and the last option of the menu, the logger. We'll press enter over here. We can log all the data of different values. Data has inbuilt 8 GB of memory, so that different type of values and different parameters can be logged inside this, and you can carried out using a USB, which is provided on the right side. The USB and LAN connector are provided, and interval you can also select it from the every 1 second. You can log the data at every 2 seconds, 5, 10, at every 1 minute, 2 minutes, 5, 10 minutes, 30 minutes or 60 minutes. And you can take up to 2 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours, 12 hours or 2 days, up to 7, 8, 9 and different values. You can take the data and put the system for data logging. The file will be saved in the memory. For minimum 2 hours, data duration can be logged, and for you can provide any of the name for data logging using this for saving the file with the required time. You can also use the timed and immediate data logging. So you can select the time where you want to start the logging, or you can select the data to log immediately. Just press start, the data are now starts to logging, and when you press the save button, the data will be automatically logged. Here the values are now reached, and press save. The file is saved successfully. Press enter to continue. Exit. Also, you can select the parameter, what the parameters you just want to see and monitor in the data. So you can select different parameters provided on this screen. Any of the parameter you can select. Now we have to move to the scope mode. The details of different menu sections has been explained. So we now see the working of scope mode, the scope key. So as I press the scope key, here you can see this is the scope diagram of this. So press F2 for matching the 1x scope. For this, the voltage RMS value is now shown. The screen header shows the RMS value of the waveform. The RMS value of line 1, line 2 and line 3 are given. The second point is about to show the frequency of the system, which is 15.07 Hz, and the third is the display area of voltage and current waveforms. The function keys are required to select any of the function. From the F1, we can see right now it is the voltage waveform. And as I press the F1, the tab moves to the A, which is showing that these are the current waveforms. There are some ripples in this current. These are the neutral waveforms of line 1. Neutral is not connected to this system, so there is no neutral waveform provided. L2, the line 3 voltage and currents are provided, and line 3 voltage and current phase shift also you can see on this, both the waveform of voltage and current. So this is how we can see, and the cursor is also movable to the different values so that you can check the value waveforms using this cursor also. So this is the scope mode by which you can check all the waveforms of this, any of the system that is connected to this analyzer. Now moving to the monitor key, by which we can monitor all the parameters continuously on this analyzer. So we can set the duration of 2 hours to the maximum, whatever we want to set. And also we can set the monitoring data to the time. We can set the time at where we are going to start the monitoring of the system. So we are going to start the monitoring immediately, so we'll press F5. Here the system monitoring is now start. In some time the data values will be starts logging. The F1 key for this RMS voltage and event tables and trends are selected from this. Harmonics bar graph from F2 can be selected, and events and table trends are provided of this. F3 flicker is not provided in this analyzer. Dips, interruption, rapid voltage change and swells are can be checked from this F4 menu for monitoring, and the unbalanced frequency are also events and tables are provided on this F5 menu for this monitoring section. With the direction keys, you can position the cursor on a particular graph. Measuring the data belonging to the bar is shown in the screen header. So this is 50 hertz and for VRMS stable trends we can see the events at the time and date provided. Trends of the voltage are also provided. These are the frequencies, event and balance and frequencies graph. At this position you can observe dips and swells are also provided on this, and these are the harmonics graph which is provided in the limits. So right now the complete power distribution system is not connected. For this is for only the observation and displaying the features, so that when you connect the analyzer to a perfect quality analyzer system or the power system to analyze the quality and the different values of this, so that all the values will be observed and monitored on this section as well. Now we move to the memory key. In the memory section, as I described earlier, the power quality analyzer comes with the inbuilt 8 GB of memory, so that different type of data logs and memories can be stored in the memory section. As we press memory, the different memory lists are provided with the date and time and the name that we have provided to this memory section. So you can select the screen and the value type for this. So as we, you can see the screen also, so that press F3. This is the data log screen on the 6th of April 2021 at this time that we have logged this screen for this memory. Similarly, this is the current measurement screen and different values. When we connect a USB to the system, all the data can be also moved to the USB, and to deleting the memory and data logs you just need to press the delete button over here. So as we press the delete, just press F1 or F2 for selecting yes or no. So we have deleted the data for this, and this can be also stored in the PC connected, from where you can directly download the memory files to the software using the software in the PC. Now at the last, the save button. The save button is provided for saving the screen. Whatever the screen is going on, you can just enter the name of the screen and just press OK. The screen will be saved in the memory. So we can go to memory and see the screen 5. That is our main menu on this. You can save the scope memory also. This is the scope that we are observing right now. So we can save this screen as a screen 6, change the name, whatever you want to use, save the data also. Press OK. The screen will be saved in the memory. For seeing it, here you can see this is the complete screen that we have saved from this save option. This can be also downloaded in the USB. Just connect the USB to this system. So that's how we can observe the different values and different monitoring. I have also explained the complete working of this. This is the power button that we have already discussed, and this is the brightness button. So you can select in the 3-degree position of the brightness. This is at the full one, this is the lower than full, this is more lower, and this is the lowest. So for the lowest working, the battery consumption will be very least for this, and at the highest brightness the battery consumption will be highest for the system. So according to your requirements, you can use different type of brightness settings.
Now on the right side, you can observe this is the charging slot of this. So adapter can be connected to this charging slot. And you can observe the charging LED starts blinking, that indicating that the system is in charging mode. So we'll remove this, and this is the compartment in which you can connect the USB and the LAN cable for the communicating and controlling this system remotely through the PC. So LAN cable can be connected to this slot. Software is provided with this. Software is very easy to use, so you can easily use the software so that all the monitoring can be done remotely from the PC at any of the location. And USB slot is provided, so when you connect the USB to this section, all the data from the analyzer can be stored on the USB. So this was the complete demonstration of Power and Harmonics analyzer. You can use this analyzer as I described in this video. All the most important basic features that I have suggested and described in this video. Also, you can refer the user manual. All the details about different operation features are given in the user manual. For better understanding of different modes and operation, you can use and study the user manual also. So if you like the content of this video and you get the knowledge about the Power Harmonics analyzer and this type of instrument, and if you want to find that how you can learn about the different type of instruments also, please subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of videos with different type of educational trainer with the hands-on practical experience are uploaded, so you can get the different type of knowledge and get clear your educational topics. You can also share this video to your friends, to your colleagues, to your classmates, those who want to learn about the this type of Power Harmonics analyzer, how this instrument works in the industries right now. And also, don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video, you will get the notification about that as well. Till then, thank you for watching this video, and we will meet in the next video very soon.